Now, if you would, please turn in your hymnals to 698, God of the Ages.
Now, friends, let us pray together the opening prayer, which is found in your bulletin. Lord God Almighty, in whose name the founders of this country won liberty for themselves and for us, and lit the torch of freedom for nations then unborn, grant that we and all the people of this land may have grace to maintain our liberties in righteousness and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
United States Marine Corps. United States Navy. United States Coast Guard. United States Air Force.
I want to say a special word of gratitude to Conductor Emeritus Colonel Gary Lamb for conducting. Conductor Emeritus of the U.S. Army Band. What an honor it is to have Gary and Alita back with us. And also I want to say a special word of gratitude to Brigadier General John Geiger. For his leadership with the South Carolina State Guard, who has been with us as our standard bearers. And now I'd like to introduce you to Reverend Butch Blackwell. As many of you know, this week in the United Methodist Church has been moving day this past Wednesday, and Reverend Butch Blackwell is now among us, and so I'm going to call upon him now to to offer our prayer. Butch, it's so good to have you with us.
Good morning. Karen and I are delighted to be with you. We're excited about the opportunities of joining in ministry with you, and we thank you very much for your warm welcome this morning. At this time, I'd like to ask if my family would please stand. My wife, Karen, my daughter, Allison, my grandson, Clarkson, and our twin grandchildren, who are four, Anna Rast and Sims. Let us now continue our time of worship as we remember that historic creed of our Christian faith, the Apostles' Creed, which you will find printed in your bulletin. Please rise. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
You may be seated. And our other new clergy person, Butch, is our nurture pastor. Reverend Tresco Edward Shannon is our program pastor, and he's now going to lead us in our pastoral prayer.
Thank you, Tim. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our gracious God, as we approach the Independence Day of our great nation, we pause to express our profound gratitude for our many blessings. We thank you for those who risked their lives and their fortunes to establish this country in a democratic fashion. We thank you for the vision of a land with freedom and opportunity. We thank you for the values which motivated and drove our founding fathers and mothers to provide for free expression of religion. We thank you for the checks and the balances written into our Constitution to protect us all from tyranny by a few. We thank you for the vision and hope of democracy. We thank you for the continuing vision to work for a more perfect nation. Lord, give us the courage in our time to embrace good values and to find ways to make our nation more temperate and more just. Help us to excel not only in the virtues of character, but also to excel in seriously developing generous spirits to aid the needy peoples of this earth. As we go about the business of being citizens in this great land, protect us from giving in to the shallowness of cheap slogans and simplistic solutions to difficult problems. Protect us from divisiveness and disrespect for those who differ from us. Protect us from cynicism about the future and denying the power of hope because we mistakenly long for a simpler world and think our best days are past. Challenge us, Lord, to assume our responsibility for the fabric of our life together and to work for justice for all. In Christ's name we most humbly pray. Amen.
Well, may we pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and power forever. And now I'd like to invite our ushers to come forward for our morning's tithes and offerings and pray that we give as God has given to us. Our hymn is number 696, America the Beautiful. Before I read our scripture lesson, I want to remind you once again that there's a free lunch. And you know, in America, there's no such thing as a free lunch, but indeed this is. As a part of the gratitude to our service personnel, men and women who stood moments ago during their service anthems, in gratitude to them and also as a gift to this community, we have this service every year. So this meal is for you. So please come, if you would, to the gymnasium. We'll have barbecue and hot dogs and slaw and all the fixings. It'll be 4th of July a bit early. So please come. Our scripture lesson from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 9, verse 57 and following. As they were walking along the road, a man said to Jesus, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus replied, "Foxes have dens and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lay his head." He said to another man, "Follow me." And he replied, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." And Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God." And still another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but first let me go back and say goodbye to my family." And Jesus replied, "No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for service in the kingdom of God." This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God, indeed. 243 years ago this coming Thursday, on July the 4th, Benjamin Franklin walked out of what we know of as today Independence Hall in Philadelphia and said, "We have given you a republic, if you can keep it. So how do we keep it? What do we need to do? Jesus addressed the same answer to his followers, the same sort of answer that we need to think about as Americans. People came to him and said, I'll follow you wherever you go, but... And Jesus answered, no one puts his hand to the plow and looks back as fit for service in the kingdom of God is a good message to all of us, not just as Christians, but as citizens of this great land. Indeed, we are not to look back, but to look forward. The genius of Christianity, as well as the genius of America, is that we are given the privilege of looking forward, looking forward. That we believe our better days are yet to come. It's summed up in that one phrase, good, better, best. Never let it rest until your good is better and your better is best. Good, better, best. Never let it rest until your good is better and your better is best. A North Korean defector moved to an apartment in Chicago, and his new neighbor asked him what his apartment was like back in North Korea, and the North Korean said, I couldn't complain. What about your job? Asked the Chicagoan. He said, I couldn't complain. What about the food? And again, he said, I couldn't complain. And so the fellow from Chicago said to the North Korean defector, if it wasn't something you could complain about, then why did you come to the U.S.? And he answered simply, here I can complain. But the freedom that we enjoy today, the freedom that we celebrate today, is not a freedom to just complain. God has given us inalienable rights so that we can do something about the problems that we have, about the injustices that we face. We don't just complain as Americans. We get busy because we know that talk is cheap. We know that talk is cheap, whether as Christians or as citizens. Charlie Brown and Peppermint Patty are talking together in a Peanuts cartoon strip, and Peppermint Patty asked Charlie Brown, do all fairy tales begin with once upon a time? And Charlie Brown replied, no, some of them begin with, if I'm elected, I promise to. Indeed. Reminds me of some events of recent days. Alexis de Tocqueville came to the United States from France. He was a social philosopher and a political science person. He came to America in the 1830s, and this is what he said about the reason that America is great. He said, I sought for the key to the greatness and genius of America in her harbors, in her fertile fields and boundless forests, in her rich mines and vast world commerce, in her public school system and institutions of higher learning. I sought for it in her Democratic Congress and her matchless Constitution. Not until I went into the churches of America. Not until I went into the churches of America and heard her pulpits flame with righteousness did I understand the secret of America's genius and power. America is great because America is good. And if America ever ceases to be good, America will cease to be great. How true that is. Some of you came here today hoping that there are indeed better days for America. Some of us came here today because of the plight that we feel that our moral values are in. But most of us have come here today because we know that we need God's help. For God to be with us, to restore us, and to move us forward beyond divisiveness and hurt. Freedom and discipleship are costly endeavors. Broad is the way, Jesus said. Broad is the way that leads to destruction, but narrow is the way that leads to eternal life. Indeed, it's a narrow way. Once in England, at a conference, General Colin Powell, both former general and secretary of state, was asked by the Archbishop of Canterbury if our plans for the Middle East were just another example of land grabbing by the United States. I love Powell's answer. Powell turned around and answered, saying, over the years, Over the years, the United States has sent many of its finest young men and women into great peril to fight for freedom beyond our borders. The only amount of land we have ever asked for in return is enough to bury our dead who couldn't come home. And with that being said, on this patriotic Sunday, I want you to give an ear and open your eyes to see the sights and sounds of John Williams, famous composer, his hymn to the fallen. Would you listen and look to the screen? Freedom is not free. We thank you and we thank them. Now may we stand as we sing together hymn number 697, America, My Country, 'Tis of Thee. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon our valiant dead, our servicemen and women who have fought to protect our liberties, and upon all of us as citizens of this great land. May the love of God the Father and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the comfort and courage of the Holy Spirit be with us and remain with us. And may God bless the food that we're about to partake. And may God grant us the grace and the strength to make America a great country throughout its history. Amen.